Dear Canadians, chers Canadiens, esteemed colleagues and dear friends, what a great pleasure to welcome all of you to the official unveiling of the Academic Health Institutions Declaration on Planetary Health. Health is not a luxury. Health is not an expenditure. Health is a human right, and if we want to be, as a society, prosper, we need to invest on health. We must set a new direction. We need to elevate the importance of protection and promotion of health. This has to be our top priority. I don't need to tell you how the pandemic was a reminder of the strong linkages between human health, environmental health, and animal health. And it was only, as well, the way to remind all of us that we need to prevent diseases. We need to go upstream. We need to address the root causes of diseases. The enormous strain on health systems worldwide these past 3 years also highlights an urgent need to reevaluate the global health architecture and a need to invest in pandemic preparedness and intersectoral approaches such as One Health and Planetary Health. Human health depends so much on the health of ecosystems that surround us. In fact, and this is an estimation of the World Health Organization of many years ago, a quarter of the global burden of diseases, which means almost 14 million deaths every year, can be attributed to environmental risk factors, such as air pollution, climate change that will exacerbate everything, nutrition, and lack of clean water and adequate sanitation. And these deaths can be avoided. This is the critical message. We could avoid 14 million deaths every year by promoting a healthier, fairer, and of course, applying greener policies. The health gains from global transition to clean energy will repay the cost of investments twice over. Can you think about that? Twice over. The climate crisis remains the largest and most complex existential challenge of our time, and it needs a completely different action. That's why public health professionals can and should, we should play a key role in advocating for a change on leading those transitions that are so critically important for us. Last year, the WHO Civil Society Working Group to Advance Action on Climate Change and Health released an open letter calling to strengthen climate change education for health professionals. And this letter is addressed to all education stakeholders to ensure health professionals are well prepared to identify, prevent, and respond to the health impacts of climate change and environmental degradation. Preparing health professionals for a future impacted by climate change is a big responsibility, and is a responsibility of all education stakeholders, including the deans, academics, managers, and other teaching staff of health professional educational institutes, as well as the associated accrediting, examination, and licensing bodies. This open letter is a starting point to engage in further curriculum development and advocacy. And it was launched at the COP27 in Egypt, in Sharm el Sheikh, and will hopefully continue to attract attention on the way to COP28. I'm very happy that the colleagues from the Association of Faculties of Medicine of Canada are launching today the Academic Health Institutions Declaration on Planetary Health. Big congratulations on your leadership. And I'm sure that you will be guiding us on action in advising planetary health. We need you as champions, and I am convinced that together we will make that incredible change that we all need. Thank you very much.